You're watching Tag TV. You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Usman Jafri with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show with the International Yoga Day, which was celebrated with great enthusiasm and fervor across the globe. People in India, where the concept of yoga was originated, held numerous congregations and events to mark the day. A large number of people pledged to adopt yoga for a healthy life. A report.
Thousands rolled out their mats as Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi led a massive congregation in the city of Dehradun into performing a wide range of yogic asanas on the occasion of the 4th International Yoga Day on 21st June. As many as 50,000 enthusiasts stretched, bent and breathed in coherence with the yoga instructors, marking the day which reached to this prominence owing to extensive lobbying by India, which is the real land of yoga. While addressing the gathering, Modi asserted on the benefits of asanas and appealed his countrymen to include yoga in their regime in order to achieve a calm and content life.
The way to lead a calm, creative and content life is yoga. It can show the way in defeating tensions and mindless anxiety.
Indian yoga guru Baba Ramdev set a new world record by holding the largest yoga session for 90 minutes in Indian city of Kota. Baba Ramdev has been instrumental in bringing the yoga to prominence in India and has inspired millions into following a life inclusive of yoga. Globally, a large number of people have started practicing yoga since June 21st was declared unanimously as Yoga Day by the United Nations General Assembly in 2014. Meanwhile, officials at the Embassy of United States of America and France in New Delhi too organized a program to mark the day, celebrating the ancient disciple.
I do yoga almost every day. I've been doing it now for about 15 years. I think it's almost the perfect exercise, especially for me as I've gotten older. It's keeping me young.
Yes, it is indeed a very good initiative taken by the embassy to showcase our love to yoga on this very special day. This embassy is specific because it's the only one that offers yoga classes to the staff members during lunch break. And this is something very important because we believe here at the embassy that yoga can increase the wellness and the well-being of our staff members, and that's why we are very committed to yoga.
The word yoga derives from Sanskrit and symbolizes the union of body and consciousness, and similar to its capacity to unite the body, mind and soul, yoga has played a big role in binding the world, cutting across linguistic and cultural barriers. People across the world did yoga for health, success, well-being and peace. Undeterred by the continuous drizzling, a large number of people performed yoga asanas at Nepal Police Academy in Kathmandu. They performed various asanas under the guidance of an expert who explained the benefits of various yogic exercises.
हम योग करके बहुत अच्छा लगा और हम चाहते हैं कि इस योग से और भी सब जुड़े ताकि हमारा जो ये देश है चाहे वो भारत हो या नेपाल वो अपने और उन्नति करे.
Yoga that was once considered a forte and regime of saints and seers of the Himalayan mountains has today been embraced by all across the world. It is known to improve flexibility, posture, muscle strength, blood flow, immunity, sleep and focus, and this list is by no means exhaustive. In 2014, the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, asked members of the United Nations to adopt an International Yoga Day in order to help improve global health, well-being, sustainable development and move towards lifestyles that are in harmony with nature. The proposition was accepted and our first International Yoga Day was held in 2015.
Yoga, a discipline that dates back thousands of years, has gained immense international prominence over the last several decades as a holistic regime for the mind and body. Moving on. Now we talk about the much-awaited book by the activist and journalist Reham Khan, who is believed to have exposed her former husband, cricketer-turned-politician Imran Khan, and many others in Pakistan. She says that the book is her autobiography and talks about the people who have affected her life in one way or the other. We spoke to Reham to know more about her controversial book.
An activist, journalist and an aspiring author, Reham Khan got fame when she got married to Imran Khan, a famed Pakistani cricketer turned politician, in January 2015. Her relation with Imran ended in just 9 months, but she is now back in news after excerpts of her upcoming book got leaked. It is believed that book talks about Imran Khan's private and political life. An overseas Pakistani, Reham Khan, said her upcoming autobiography, Tell All, has become a center of controversy, not because it was leaked, but for containing the truth.
किताब actually मेरी जिंदगी के बारे में है तो हर एक को हक होना चाहिए कि वो अपनी जिंदगी की जो आप बीती है जो कहानी है वो बताए और मेरी जिंदगी जाहिर है काफी दिलचस्प है कुछ पहलू आपको मालूम है कि क्यों दिलचस्प है और कुछ पहलू आपको नहीं मालूम लेकिन मुझे लगता है कि बहुत सी औरतें बहुत सी खवातीन जब पढ़ेंगी तो उनको शायद अपनी कोई कहानी बीच में दिखाई दे अल्लाह करे कि सारी कहानियां उनके साथ ना हुई हो जो मेरे साथ हुआ है लेकिन कोई ना कोई पहलू आपको आपके साथ भी हुआ होगा तो मेरी बड़ी जिंदगी में मैंने बहुत से जो तजर्बे हैं एक्सपीरियंसेस हैं वो बहुत अजीब और अजीबोगरीब हुए हैं तो जाहिर है जरा दिलचस्प कहानी है इसके अलावा मेरी जिंदगी के बारे में एक सोच है कि मेरा मानना यह है कि जिंदगी में अगर कोई भी मुश्किल वक्त आए या कोई भी प्रॉब्लम आए तो मैं उसको प्रॉब्लम के तौर पे सोचती नहीं हूं
रिहाम आल्सो सेड दैट शी रिसीव्ड डेथ थ्रेट्स फॉर रिलीजिंग द बुक
मुझे बहुत ज्यादा डेथ थ्रेट्स भी आ रहे हैं मेरे बच्चों को जो लोग मेरे साथ दिखाई देते हैं उनको फॉलो किया जा रहा है लेकिन अगर हम सब बुजदिल हो जाएंगे अगर हम सब लोगों से डरने शुरू हो जाएंगे अपने क्रिएटर से नहीं डरेंगे मैं तो उसको जवाब दे हूं मैं इनको तो जवाब दे नहीं हूं
रिहाम खान आल्सो फेस्ड क्रिटिसिज्म फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान्स फॉर्मर प्रेसिडेंट जनरल परवेज मुशर्रफ In his official tweet, Musharraf had accused Reham of working on the agenda of Nawaz Sharif's Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz to allegedly defame the chief of the Pakistan, Tehreek-e-Insaf, and Reham's ex-husband, Imran Khan.
General Parvez Musharraf ne bhi aaj tweet kiya hai, official tweet kiya hai, aur wo keh rahe hai ki ek lady ko aise bolna nahi chahiye. Yani ke mard jo kuch aaye kare, lekin lady wo kaam dekhe bhi to bole nahi. सवाल यह है क्यों क्यों ना बोले कौन डिसाइड करेगा कि लेडी क्या बोले क्या लिखे क्या चीज एक्सपोज करे ये बात गलत है
Earlier, Imran Khan filed a petition to stop Reham's autobiography being published in Pakistan, following which a stay order was issued on her book launch. However, Reham Khan is optimistic of getting her book released soon.
Moving on to the illegally occupied territory of Pakistan, where people continue to face a unequal treatment at the hands of suppressive Pakistani rulers. In recent developments, a shocking video has surfaced in which the Chief Secretary of Gilgit-Baltistan is seen hurling demeaning and derogatory remarks at the poor activists of the region on a mere question of the state of medical affairs in the region. A report.
आप गवर्नमेंट को कितना टैक्स देते हैं बताएं मुझे कितना टैक्स देते हैं बताइए
सर हम जो ना
कितना टैक्स दिया आपने एक रुपया दिया
मुतनाज़े
करें आप मुतनाज़े ना करनी है इसको हुकूमत पाकिस्तान 100 रुपया देती है आपने कितना दिया
This Islamabad stooge, who happens to be the chief secretary of Gilgit-Baltistan, lashed out at a local activist in an utterly insensitive and derogatory tone, calling him and the people of the region a liability on the state of Pakistan. Local's fault was that he wanted the chief secretary to address the despicable state of affairs of the health sector in the region. However, it did not go well with the Pakistani official. The remarks have sparked a fresh row of protests and people have taken to the streets of various parts of the region. The Falahi Committee of Ganche called for strike and protest in Khaplu, Skardu and other parts of Gilgit-Baltistan, seeking his immediate ouster from the post.
आपके इस स्टेटमेंट से तासुब की बदबू आती है मुझे खौफ आता है उस वक्त से जब आपका इस किस्म का इल मैनर्ड एटीट्यूड लासानियत कौमियत और सुबाइयत का रंग ले लेगा हुकूमत पाकिस्तान की तरफ से मुसलसल गिलगित बल्तिस्तान के लोगों के लिए कभी जीबी ऑर्डर्स और कभी पीआईए की तरफ से जीबी के लोगों के लिए के साथ थर्ड क्लास सिटीजंस जैसा सलूक काबिले मुज़म्मत है
Locals say that Pakistan has been earning billions from Gilgit-Baltistan in lieu of tourism taxes, minerals and trade with China. These federal earnings will increase exponentially with the progress of multi-billion dollar CPEC project. However, the people who have the prerogative over the resources have remained bereft of any dividends. It is not just the region of Gilgit-Baltistan, but Pakistan-occupied Kashmir has also remained under Pakistani subjugation for more than seven decades. People who have been reeling under an oppressive Islamabad rule took to the streets of Muzaffarabad city demanding to abolish the Azad Kashmir Council headed by the Prime Minister of Pakistan. They have demanded constitutional amendments in Interim Act 1974 of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir to ensure full empowerment of the elected government of POK through transfer of all powers of the Kashmir Council to the government.
इन मेंबरान असेंबली ने कश्मीर कौंसिल के जिन्होंने कश्मीर कौंसिल के जो अमायत के लिए उन्होंने कहा जी कि कश्मीर कौंसिल ख़त्म नहीं होनी चाहिए हम इसकी भरपूर मजम्मत करते हैं और उन चोर और उन अवारियों मेंबरान कश्मीर कौंसिल जिनकी तादाद छः है उनको ये बता देना चाहते हैं कि वो अपने दाल दलिया के लिए जो है कश्मीर कौंसिल की जो फंडिंग के लिए अपने आप को जो है वो एक नाम नहाद कश्मीर कौंसिल के मेम्बर बन के जो है कश्मीरियों के हकूक पर डाका डालना चाहते हैं हम इसकी भरपूर मजम्मत करते हैं और उन्हें यह भी बता देना चाहते हैं उन्हें मेंबरान असेंबली जो कश्मीर कौंसिल के हैं अगर उन्होंने अपनी रवज को तब्दील ना किया तो हम उन्हें जूतियां मारेंगे और सरेआम मारेंगे और ये जूतियां अगर इस्लामाबाद मारनी पड़ी तो उधर मारेंगे मुजफ्फराबाद मारनी पड़ी तो उधर मारेंगे क्योंकि आज़ाद कश्मीर के जो वकार पे है आज़ाद कश्मीर के जो हकूक पे है किसी को हम सौदाबाजी करने की इजाज़त नहीं देंगे
Pakistan has misruled the region for more than seven decades. There is a prime minister and president in POK, but they are merely stooges who have been helping Islamabad fill its treasuries through economic depredations. The people of the region have been denied basic fundamental rights and are meted out with severe brutality if they demand it.
The people of the region have been denied basic fundamental rights and are meted out with severe brutality if they demand for it. Moving on to Indian Foreign Minister Sushma Swaraj's four-nation visit to Italy, France, Luxembourg and Belgium to further strengthen India's bilateral and multilateral ties with the European countries. India has not only been enhancing its trade and cultural ties with the European countries, but has also been focusing at building its soft power in the region. A report.
Indian Foreign Minister Sushma Swaraj, working towards establishing a strong Indian foreign policy and further strengthening the bilateral and multilateral ties, called on her counterparts and state heads from four different European countries. Swaraj reviewed the entire gamut of India-France bilateral ties, which has particularly gained strength after the French President Emmanuel Macron's visit to India earlier this year, when both countries had signed contracts worth $16 billion and inaugurated a 100-megawatt solar plant. While releasing the joint statement with her counterpart Dryan, Swaraj sought French support in fighting and curbing the menace of terrorism that has severely affected both countries in the recent times.
हमारे समाजों को सुरक्षित रखना हम दोनों देशों की प्राथमिकता है। इसलिए इस क्षेत्र में हमारी विभिन्न एजेंसियों के बीच सहयोग और आतंकवादियों को दिए जाने वाले धन का मुकाबला करने के लिए हम आपस में सहयोग करेंगे।
The two nations also agreed to work towards achieving stronger partnership in the fields of urbanization, science and technology, clean energy, transportation and infrastructure sectors. Ties between France and India have grown in recent years, most notably in the defense sector, with New Delhi ordering 36 French-made Rafale fighter jets to modernize its warplane fleet. Dryan reassured his country's stance on the creation of Indo-Pacific region.
L'Inde est l'un de nos tout premiers partenaires en Asie et réciproquement, je suis convaincu, Madame la Ministre, que la France a vocation à devenir le premier partenaire stratégique de l'Inde en Europe. Notre relation est déjà dense et riche, comme l'ont illustré les engagements pris en mars dernier. Je mentionnerai en particulier notre coopération dans l'océan Indien, dont la valeur se mesure à l'aune de l'importance croissante que la France entend accorder à l'espace Indo-Pacifique. On pourrait aussi évoquer notre coopération dans le domaine spatial.
Swaraj also called on President of the European Union, Jean-Claude Juncker, in Brussels as the leaders exchanged views on progress made on the understandings reached during the last India-EU-European Union summit in 2017. Swaraj also had a productive meeting with the Minister of Foreign and European Affairs of Luxembourg, Jean Asselborn. The two leaders discussed cooperation in trade and investment, steel and space, and exchanged the views on strengthening India-EU relations. The meet coincided with India and Luxembourg celebrating 70 years of establishment of the diplomatic relations. Earlier, Swaraj met her Italian counterpart, Enzo Movaro Milanese, to give boost to the bilateral ties between the two countries. Both leaders reaffirmed strong commitment to take the relationship between the two nations forward, reviewed all aspects of the bilateral relationship, and exchanged views on the regional and global issues of the mutual interest. India is Italy's fifth largest trading partner in the EU, and the bilateral trade between the two countries reached $8.7 billion in 2016.
India was one of the first countries to develop relations with the European Union. The Union is also India's largest trading partner with overall trade ahead of China and the United States. Moving on, the people of Afghanistan who have been reeling under violence for decades now are demanding the restoration of peace and harmony in the country. Recently, at least 65 activists from violence-hit provinces of Helmand, Kandahar and Herat carried out a peace march. They were greeted by all as they reached capital Kabul. A report.
Hundreds of Afghan peace marchers arrived exhausted in capital Kabul on June 18th after spending the fasting month of Ramadan, crossed the sun-baked, war-torn country, much of it under the Taliban control. The marchers, all men, including teachers, students and war victims on crutches and one in a wheelchair, were welcomed along the way by village women carrying the Holy Quran, men singing and dancing or offering bread and yogurt, some in tears. The march was triggered by a car bomb in Hemland on March 23rd that killed 14 people and wounded dozens.
د دوار اړخونو سم غوښتنه دا ده چې دوی باید سوله وکړي او اوربان مال وکړي او خپل د زړه درد لري کړي زړه درد مو د ولس درد دی چې ولس نن ورځ په وینو کې لغړي او ګوندي وایي چې مان جوړو نو په دې خاطر موږ هم د زړه درد لري کړي یو غواړو چې اوربان مال شي او دوار اړخونه سوله وکړي.
Both the government and the Taliban militants declared temporary ceasefire for the month of Ramadan Eid al-Fitr holidays, leading to hugs and selfies between the two sides as militants emerged from their hideouts to enter the towns and cities. The Taliban ceasefire, which ended on June 17th, was extended for 3 more days. However, the Taliban have killed about 30 Afghan soldiers in Badghis province in the first major attacks since the temporary ceasefire expired. Militants stormed at least two army checkpoints before ambushing reinforcements sent to help.
The security situation in Afghanistan is deteriorating as country gears up to hold general elections in October this year. Moving on to the Rohingya refugee camps of Cox's Bazar in Bangladesh, where the humanitarian situation is deteriorating at a rapid pace. People who have been living here for around 10 months are reeling under a catastrophic weather transition as torrential rains have taken a heavy toll on their flimsy shelters. A report.
Landslides triggered by the incessant torrential rains have caused massive damage to the lives and properties of the already beleaguered Rohingya refugees living in the makeshift camps of Bangladesh's Cox's Bazar. International Aid Agency said there was also a mounting fear of an outbreak of waterborne diseases in the camps, as there was no proper drainage system in a place for nearly a million people living in the shacks made of bamboo and plastic sheets that cling to steep, denuded hills.
আরা বর্মাতুন আসছি দে সারা নামাজি সারা নামাজ বাদে আর কানি এনে বাংলাদেশে তাই আশ্রয় লই আশ্রয় লই বাদে বাইরে যখন ফুজে বাদে আতিকা এর দরাই বেশি দরাই হান্দাম বা গিয়ে গই হান্দাম বাই বাদে আর দুর্ঘন মানে মানুষ তানি গালি ন এ দুর্মদ নেলি আর গান গরমদ আশ্রয় লই থাকি
Nearly 700,000 Rohingya Muslims who fled a military crackdown last year have been living in insalubrious condition owing to constantly swelling numbers of refugees, making camps more congested. The Bangladeshi government, which has reassured a concrete action into relocation of those sufferings, has not been able to meet its targets. Apart from landslides, water shortages have also plagued the life of these refugees.
আরা হইনি আরো বাংলাদেশ না আরে দেশ আরো ইন আরো বাপ দাদা হই দেশ হ্যাঁ দেশ আরো বাপ দাদা হই আরে দেশ ইচ্ছা তোমার বাঙালি আরো বাঙালি না আরো বর্মাই তাই হইলে আরো রোহিঙ্গা রোহিঙ্গা যে তোমার মাঝে হই তুমি অবহাদ নয় তোমার বাঙালি তোমার দেশ তাই নিয়ে হইতে মারা মারি ওর সুল দিয়ে আরে রাজা কইছি আল্লাহ দিন আরো সুন্দর করে জায়গা আমি পাই বাংলাদেশে বেশ সুন্দর জায়গা দিয়ে আলহামদুলিল্লাহ ইয়া তো তু মানে সরকারে বকুনে জিজ্ঞা পাইছে লাগরি কেউ আরো যা হইলে যাইম বই এ দূরের মা
Meanwhile, a number of refugees took the streets of Cox's Bazar to demand more human rights and citizenship rights on World Refugee Day. Many of them lined the streets of Kutupalong camp, holding placards with the demand to be recognized as citizens in Myanmar. For now, Myanmar is offering Rohingya national verification cards, which they have termed discriminatory, suppressive and inadequate.
তো আর তো হদিন আজ ইন্টারন্যাশনাল আছে আরজ করতে মনে হদ দে আর আর ডিমান্ড নিন আরজ আছে ফুরা করে দিয়ে বললা বলি বেকুন কোঅপারেট করি বললা আর আর আছে নিজর নিজর আছে হোমল্যান্ড অম মাঝে আর যে ডিমান্ড কল আছে ওয়া ডিমান্ড কল আছে আর আছে ফুল সিটিজেনশিপ পাই রে আর রাইট লই রে আর আর ডিগনিটি লই আর আর আছে সিকিউরিটি আপগ্রেড হওয়া লই রে আর আর দেশের মাঝে আর জলদি জায়গা ভারি বললা বলি আর ইন্টারন্যাশনাল কমিউনিটি কলরে আর বেকুন আরজ করির
The United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees has said that the number of Rohingya refugees now in Bangladesh has swelled to over 720,000.
Earlier in June, downpours and storms triggered landslides and floods, killing two refugees and damaging thousands of bamboo and plastic shelters built on the slopes of muddy brown hills. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.
You're watching Tag TV. You're watching Tag TV.